responsible for the murders in the park. When I bark, they hear the boom, but you see the spark. And I see the part of your head, which used to be your face, be replaced by nothing but bluffing. What a waste. Whoa. Niggas wanna see me taste my own medicine. Picture that, get on some old second grade shit. I'ma get you back, retaliate, cause it hate for you to think I took a loss. When all I did was shook it off, yeah, you heard me, shook it off.
Welcome back to Cards and Grill Box. It's a bad sweet box score. Margarito versus Cotto. Got my man Coltrane.
Ride or die.
Ride or die. Big Mike, Docs, fight of the year. Who's going to set this off?
You know, I'll say two things. One, it was like a bullfight, except the bull kept up with the matador eventually. He just kept missing it, and finally he just caught up with him. I've never seen a person take so many hits and just keep coming. I mean, you described it.
You did see it. You saw the shit try.
I mean, look, but this. I mean, but look, it was the difference because I didn't think, you know, no disrespect to Centron. I didn't think Centron was on Cotto's level. But the, you know, shout out to both fighters because they both did a great thing. You know, they fought each other in their primes and it was a good fight. You know, it's just that. That boy took more hits than a MySpace page. Man. He just kept coming. And I'm just really and truly surprised that he beat Cotto the way he did. Yeah. I mean, I'm...
Walked him down.
He just totally walked him down.
That sounds familiar.
He destroyed him. I'm eating crow right now. I really don't know what to say. Hopefully Cotto can, you know, repair and recover from this. But, ooh.
Well, that bull kept... There's only one winner. The fans.
Yeah,
whatever, man. Yo, listen, man. All I want to know is this: how soon after the fight did Bob Arum call Richard Schaefer and said, "All right, how much you want for the Oscar fight?" Because he just destroyed Cotto's career tonight, man. I mean, I've been sitting here for the past 2 months. We've been talking about this fight since it was made. Matter of fact,
you said first
the Centron fight in AC. I was like, they ain't fighting.
Yep,
you know.
Mysterious injury.
It might not happen. Right. Bob will never put his prize fighter in there with a beast like Margarito. But as we got closer to the fight, you know, I was very adamant that Cotto was going to outclass Margarito for the simple fact that he's a better boxer.
Before we get into all this, let's break down the fight.
Let's break the fight.
You know, some people didn't get to see the fight, so let's break it down round by round what actually happened. You want to open up Coltrane?
Yeah, I mean, Cotto came out to me, you know, I thought fighting the wrong fight from the door. I know a lot of the people that was going for Cotto was excited because he was landing a crisp and sharper punches, but he was fighting at Margarito's pace, mm-hmm. which is when I initially picked Margarito, I said, can Cotto keep it up for 12 rounds against Margarito, whatever style he's going to bring? Rather, if he's going to box, if he's going to mix it, can he do it for 12 rounds? He came on the first round. He was mixing up punches. He was slipping. He showed a nice slip game. But as my man Rada Dye said, Tony just he didn't back up one time in the first round. And the only person on the telecast, we're going to get in this later about the cheerleaders, was Max Kellerman said, yeah, it was a good round for Miguel Cotto, but Kenny keeps the pace up. So that's how the first round basically.
Well, you know what? Surprisingly, though, I thought Margarito came out a little faster than he normally would come out.
He actually did.
No, I think, yeah.
When you go back to the fight, the first round, he went into a little jab fest with Cotto. He didn't really start trying to apply. He was applying pressure, but it was with a jab. He didn't come out winging the hooks like we expected him to wing it. It was actually like a boxing match, and Cotto looked very well in the early rounds. But in the second round, when Antonio started letting punches go, I was like, did you see Cotto? I asked everybody, I said, you see Cotto take that breath? It was like he took a deep breath, like damn, like, you know what
I'm
saying?
We saw it, but the commentator.
Yeah, I remember, though, he had his nose, I don't know.
When did he crack his nose?
First round, second round.
Like, he was leaking in the second round.
When I started seeing the Q-tips going in his nose, I was like, okay, you know what? He's having breathing problems. And once you start breathing through your mouth, it's only a matter of time before you get caught.
Right.
About the sixth round, though, it just seemed like Cotto slowed down more, and Margarito just said, you know what, it's game time. Like, this is the fourth quarter now. He just turned it up, man.
But the real turning point was that body shot.
The body shot that nobody, I mean, people at home probably saw it. But the commentators totally missed it. That was like one of the most key punches in the fight.
Like right when it came
out. Yeah,
right when the round started.
Exactly. It happened so fast, and you see Cotto kind of whinge and turn, but.
What round was that?
That was the sixth. Was the sixth or the eighth?
Let's not discredit the seventh, because the seventh is when basically the momentum of the fight changed. You know,
Margarito said the sixth in his post-fight interview.
Well, the six set him up for the second.
Right, y'all remember this. These translators,
I got my man. They never actually translated.
He said that his whole strategy was when he started going at him, he started softening him up in the sixth. Okay. He started getting inside
so
and
right. set up going
to the He started, towards the end of the sixth round, he really put some pressure on him. But, you know, I've been called Nostradamus, and I'll happily accept that role.
Oh, you got a partner time, Batman.
I put that seventh round out there for the change of the fight.
Yeah, that's true. You did. So
I know by now, everybody in America has seen Batman.
Right.
Why is no one smiling?
Was that metaphor accurate?
About the Joker. We called him the Joker, man.
Harvey Two-Faced Dent.
Yep.
His luck ran out.
Yeah.
Pick a side. Big Mike.
Big Mike.
Something to say on the fight?
Well,
Miguel Cotto. Miguel Grande, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, Miguel Grande here tonight in honor of Puerto Rico and Mexico. What can I say? I thought Miguel Cotto didn't fight the fight that he should have fought. He didn't do anything different than Kermit Cintron did. Other than that, the slip game was a little better.
Mm-hmm. A lot better.
He was a lot better than Kermit Cintron. He sat there and just went toe-to-toe.
Well,
I think Miguel sat in the pocket as well. I think Miguel took a lot of shots. I didn't think he moved like he should have moved. Did you see him go to the body?
He didn't go to the body.
That's the thing he was missing. But don't.
Sleep got a perspective with his body thing.
Well, I think.
Well, let me just finish my analysis.
But you say he moved well. He moved well.
He moved way better.
He moved the whole fight. That's what got him so tired. Yeah. He was moving well.
Antonio Margarito is. I mean, y'all make him out to be this Jason or this
he is. He is. Right. Say his full name,
Jason Voorhees.
You know,
Fred Krueger.
It's the way you fight him is you can beat him. And Miguel Cotto didn't fight him that way. Kermit Cintron didn't fight him that way. Paul Williams did fight him that way and defeated him. And yeah, he is a guy who continues to come at it. He doesn't sustain punishment. He takes hits. He takes shots. He keeps moving forward. But it seems that to fight Miguel Cotto, you have to throw a lot of punches. You got to give him a lot of angles. You got to give him a lot of punches. Mm-hmm. And you just cannot sit like I saw Miguel Cotto go on ropes like this. You know.
But the thing is, Cotto was not in the shape to do that.
Trying to make Cotto be something. See, this was my problem from the beginning with the media.
First of all, and I'm making him see. Cotto normally goes to the body on his opponent.
He does, but
did he do that this time?
Body calls commitment. You gotta stay and commit too.
If he didn't go to the body, he normally goes to the body. That means he's out of character.
Right, he didn't fight his fight. He did another thing.
But did
the opponent dictate that though?
Right, but here's the thing. I understand y'all saying
Cotto
that.
Cotto just
I understand that, but listen. All I wanted to see is just see it for one round.
You gotta commit to go to the body.
One round. That's all I want to see. That commitment for one round.
I think this is my whole thing is, you know, and this has nothing to do with y'all. This has to do with the fans out there. Because I always say I take everything on the chin when I'm wrong.
I don't care about being wrong.
Cotto fought the best possible fight that he could fight.
Thank you.
It's just physically, he is not the type of fighter to deal with Margarito. His foot movement was extraordinary. He was countering with crazy combinations. But as I said from day one, he will not be able to sustain that pace. And another thing was, Margarito would miss the first, second punch.
He'll touch the third
or fourth punch. If he was running, he would hit touch the body. He would touch him a little bit. And that started wearing him down. That and all the movement that he had to be on his bike. Like, he was like, he hit this guy. The famous part of the fight, Margarito get hit, jogging right back at him. Let's go to work.
He tried to him.
Chase him all around.
And that's the warning. Max, I gotta give my man Max his props.
You like that?
Max kept saying it like psychologically that has to have an effect on a fighter. Sleep uses the word uncomfortable. When you fight Margarito, he makes you feel uncomfortable. And let me get back to Big Mike about Paul Williams. You can't make Cotto be 6'2 and have an 82-inch reach. He's a southpaw. The styles is totally different. That's why when I picked Margarito, it was all about the physical intangibles of the fight. Cotto's 5'7". Yeah, he had exceptional feet work, but it's not like a Mayweather S type feet work or Roy Jones type feet work.
Size beats some seasons.
I think not just on my size. You gotta have nice limb, like you said, the angles. But you can't make Paul Cotto be 5'11". He's 5'7". That's not no knock on him. Like I said, when we made the prediction, you got a pot shot and constantly move. When I watched the Shane fight, I saw something. If you didn't see the fight, go back and watch it again, please. Cotto got hurt in that fight and he got on his bike and he was running. I said in our previous shows, he cannot do that against Tony Margarito. Because he's not going to do like Shane and let up. He's going to keep the heat coming, and that's basically what he did.